You can see some rotation around the main tornado.
You can see behind me, this roof is crushed.
This looks like a graveyard for boats.
Destructive hurricanes and life-changing tornadoes.
There's the vortex right there. Look at that tree bending.
It picked up and tossed this RV.
Relentless storms and bitter winter weather.
Blizzard conditions here in Wells, Maine.
The snow is falling, pelting you in the face.
Heat soaring to record highs.
The heat emergency in the city is getting extended.
Wildfires out of control.
All that smoke coming from active fire burning very close here.
And historic flooding scarring the landscape.
The pictures and videos of the devastation don't do justice.
Snapshots of extreme weather impacting all of us this year. One weather event will go down as the most damaging of 2022.
Winds now 150 miles an hour, down from the 155.
The early images out of Southwest Florida because of Hurricane Ian are hard to swallow.
Hurricane Ian striking Florida September 28th, a forceful Category 4 storm decimating the West Coast near Fort Myers Beach and Naples.
I've literally 20 years I've been here. This is my fifth hurricane. This is the worst one I've ever been through.
Yeah, me too.
Unbelievable.
Storm surge ripped out roads and bridges, cutting off coastal islands.
I guess this area hasn't had any help.
In central Florida, Ian dumped in excess of 20 inches of rain in just a matter of hours.
The relentless rain pushed the St. Johns River into these homes.
And this fifth strongest hurricane to ever make a landfall in the U.S. is carving a new Florida coastline.
We just want to take you down to the surface. Look at this house. Lost his porch, seawall wiped out. This is going to be a massive recovery effort here.
Wait. I see a tornado. There it is. This looks like it's at Arabee.
Arabee, Louisiana, March 22nd. WDSU is on the air. Their cameras capture the start of a record EF3 tornado.
Tornado on the ground, moving northeast.
The near 160 mile per hour winds tear up an 11 mile path in just 17 minutes.
The damage out here in Arabee, it is incredible and massive. You can see a car flipped on its side.
It's more than I can talk about without really just becoming hysterical.
This tornado, the strongest ever for the New Orleans area. This is going to hit Seminole pretty much head on. Oh my gosh, look at that, guys. One tornado after another struck Seminole County, Oklahoma in a single day during the peak of tornado season in May.
This is a bad situation for Seminole.
Oklahoma's tornado season slightly below average this year. But over time, the tornado trend is changing. Longer stretches of quiet weather, but the active days are more active than ever.
A large tornado on the ground.
A March 5th EF4 tornado in Iowa was the strongest ever recorded so far north so early in the year. And in Springdale, Arkansas, a direct hit.
This whole row of houses behind me was severely damaged.
There's a chair right there that held the tree up, and that's what saved my life.
And this was the strongest tornado of the year, April 5th in Bryan County, Georgia.
As you can see behind me, trees are snapped in half, windows broken.
An unusual EF4 tornado with winds estimated at 185 miles an hour.
There used to be a cabin. There was another house just beyond here that was carried away.
Flash flooding, just as powerful as any tornado or hurricane. Take a look at the catastrophic damage in eastern Kentucky in late July.
The house, it just picked up and just turned sideways and just floated into the trees and just demolished.
6 to 10 inches of rain. You say to yourself, that's a lot of rainfall, and it is a lot of rain. But this came over a short period of time.
Upwards of 16 inches of rain over 5 days, something the National Weather Service calls historically unheard of. And in Jackson, Mississippi, the rising water wasn't as rapid, but it was just as damaging.
The Pearl River predicted to crest less than an hour at 35 and a half feet, flooding streets and endangering hundreds of homes.
Intense August rain pushed a major reservoir near its limit, so overflow was sent into the Pearl River, which then spilled into neighborhoods.
A lot of flooding, all the way up, almost over mailboxes.
We got everybody out, and that's the most important thing.
The flooding exposed the nation to years of trouble with Jackson's neglected, malfunctioning water plant. The influx of water putting it entirely offline for weeks and igniting a crisis as 150,000 residents struggled to get drinking water. And in the Northeast, a relatively slow start to winter accelerated by the end of January.
We're seeing whiteout conditions and those winds over 50 miles per hour at times.
It is treacherous out here right now.
A stinging blizzard delivered massive surge along the New England coast.
We're measuring about a foot and a half of snow at this point.
And dumped near record piles of snow across the region. Even South Carolina was stuck with some unusual snowfall. This January storm broke a nearly 60-year record in the Greenville area, piling up more than a half a foot in a single day. Eventually, winter cold gave way to summer heat, the country's third warmest summer on record.
Today was the seventh straight day of 90-degree weather.
It's been like desert hot.
Heat waves all across the country, sometimes in the triple digits. Sacramento, California spent 44 days at 100 or above, with a record-setting 116-degree day in September.
These are live pictures as the big tanker dropping retardant right on the ridge of that canyon.
Heat and extreme dryness adding to the intensity of wildfires. California's mosquito fire raged for 50 days, scorching nearly 80,000 acres of land and cherished property.
You might be able to hear the booming noises. It sounds like propane tanks going off.
The sheriff came and picked us up, and he had to drive through fire to get us out.
Experts say shifting climate and weather patterns are expanding the length of the active fire season.
Where are we going to live? You know, it's very scary.